This autumn winter is the perfect time to experiment with a little gothic glamour. Dark crimson lips are a great place to start. Begin by cleansing the skin with Lancôme's Express Cleansing Water for face, eyes, and lips. This gentle cleanser doubles up as a toner and works really well on sensitive skins. Pump out the cleansing water onto two cotton pads and wipe over your face to remove any makeup and impurities. Now apply a moisturiser. We're using one of my favourite moisturisers to use on a sheet, Embryolisse, nourishing moisturiser for all skin types. It leaves the skin feeling hydrated, pampered, and perfectly prepares the skin for foundation. Massage it over the face using both hands. Before we apply the foundation, we're going to use Instant Smooth Perfecting Touch by Clarins. This primer is the perfect combination of makeup and skincare. With an ultra-light, ultra-smooth texture, it fills in and smooths away the appearance of fine lines, wrinkles, and pores. It can be used alone or mixed in with your foundation. Apply it to the T-zone and blend out using your fingers. To even out skin tone, we're using Dior's Dior Skin Nude Skin Glowing Makeup. This foundation boasts 100% natural active ingredients and an extended shade range to create a shine-free, natural glow without masking the skin's texture. With continued use, it improves the natural radiance and beauty of the skin day after day, also protecting it from the sun with an SPF of 15. Using a foundation brush, start by applying the product to the center of the face. This is where most people need the extra coverage, and work outwards, blending it in with your fingers. Sparingly work the base out to the hairline and also underneath the jawline. Now follow the same steps on the forehead. I always like to apply a little bit of foundation to the eyelids just to even out the skin tone and prepare them for the eye makeup. Made with the same skin-perfecting ingredients as the foundation, the Dior Skin Nude Concealer hides imperfections, including dark circles, to create a flawless canvas. This intensely hydrating concealer minimizes the appearance of dark circles and puffiness and leaves a smooth, velvety, natural finish. Apply the concealer around the eye area using a flat synthetic brush, then blend it in with your fingers. Notice how we're just patting it in so as not to pull the skin. Using a fluffy eye blending brush, set and mat down the eyelids using Dior Skin Nude Natural Glow Fresh Powder Foundation by Dior. Tap off any excess from your brush and then apply with sweeping strokes across the eyelids. Now the lips are the main focus of our look, so we just want to softly define the eyes. We want the eye makeup to look like you've slept in it. So we're going to apply a black painting eyeliner by Shiramura. Then we're going to blend, then slightly remove it to create the desired effect. Take a thin angled brush and using short strokes, apply the liner along the top lash line. Make sure you get it right into the roots of the lashes. Repeat these steps on the other eye. Now take a slightly larger and softer angled brush and blend the line in. It doesn't have to be perfect. Now blend it in further using a clean cotton bud to get that slept-in look. Apply a touch more powder to the eyelids and then start the same process along the bottom lash line, concentrating on the outer edge. To open up the eyes, we're using eyelash colours by Shiramura. Grip the lashes close to the roots and gently squeeze. Pump the lashes a few times and then release. To finish off the eyes, use new CK1 mascara. This handy mascara has an adjustable mascara brush that changes your look with the quick twist of the cap. Twist in the cap for voluminous lashes and twist the cap out for a more lengthened look. Here we've twisted the cap in to go for more volume on the lashes. Aim for the roots of the lashes and then pull the brush through to the tips. Then repeat the same steps on the other eye. If your bottom lashes are particularly fair and or short, it's sometimes easier to apply the mascara to a small brush and then onto the lashes. Just move the brush back and forth and the little fair lashes will soon show up. To frame the eyes, we're going to define and fill in the brows. Take a sizzly eyebrow pencil and softly fill in any gaps whilst establishing a good shape. To have more control over where you're applying the colour, just use short little strokes. Then soften the brows by brushing them through with a clean mascara wand. Repeat the same steps on the other brow. The lips are the main focus of this look, so we're going to use a MAC lipstick. MAC do such an amazing range of colours and textures, and we've found the perfect lipstick for this look. We want to create a stain-like effect, so using a lip brush, apply the majority of the colour to the centre of the lips and blend off the outer edge using your fingers. To get right into the corners, we've switched to a smaller brush. Now pout your lips and pat the colour in with your fingers. Now mat down the T-zone using the same powder as before, Dior Skin Nude Natural Glow Fresh Powder Foundation by Dior. Using a large fluffy brush, sweep the product over the cheeks, forehead and chin. To complete our look, we want to slightly warm the cheeks with a touch of Sheer Tone Powder Blush by MAC. Use a large fluffy brush to apply the colour under and on your cheekbones. So here we have our very wearable, understated goth beauty look. You can easily adapt this look for the evening by darkening the eyes and lips with more of the same products. To really pull this look off, team it up with some black glossy leather.